God good? From Bogalusa, Louisiana, Brother Jonathan Suber, there's nobody like him. Welcome him to preach to us tonight.
Well, what do you think about Jesus? I said, what do you think about Jesus? He healed my sin sick body. He filled me with the Holy Ghost. He raised me out of the miry clay. And I just stopped by to say, yay! I wish I had somebody that would look at your neighbor and say, I'll holler if I have to. I didn't come to be dignified, pontificating, perfect, or prolific, but I come to get a miracle from the Holy Ghost. I don't have time to play games, play church, or play pretty, but I come to lift up the name of the Lord. For greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. They're about to make me happy. I was thinking about how great God is. God is so good you don't even have a word in your vocabulary to explain him. We call him amazing, but amazing isn't enough. We call him great, but great isn't enough. All I can say is he's the great I am. He's the everlasting Father. He's the Prince of Peace. He's the lily of the valley. He's the great eternal wonder. Come on, somebody. He's my bread when I'm hungry. He's my water when I'm thirsty. He's my friend when I'm friendless. He's my healer when I'm hurting. He's my help when I'm helpless. He's my hope when I'm hopeless. Oh, you're not hearing me. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. We've had enough preaching up in here. We've come to see miracles tonight. I was praying today, and I do want to give honor to Brother Dean. There is no way I could have even attempted to try to preach tonight what I've been feeling God deal with my heart without that message. And he spoke something in altar call. He said, I didn't get time to tell him. But tell him I was on my face a few weeks ago saying, God, I've got this huge plant and church. Told me what it was worth and said, I'd trade it all for apostolic power. And the Lord spoke to him and said, you don't have to. That's why I went to Calvary. I've already paid the price. And as I was thinking about how great God is, I was praying this evening, and you know you can't stop God. You can't hinder God. I don't believe these preachers that say there's a devil in the sound system, and the sound system can hinder God. The sound system can hinder my voice, but it can't hinder God. A flu can slow me down, but it can't hinder God. A car wreck can stop my transportation, but it can't stop God. God is not a man that he should lie. You can't control, manipulate God. God is bigger than you are. God is bigger than your fears. God is bigger than your failure. I come to tell somebody, God is bigger than your past mistakes. And if God ever said it, he's going to look beyond your faults and he's going to see your faith. There's still a ministry for you. And I was praying, Brother Barnes, what could stop God? What could hinder God? And it dawned on me that the only door that ever stopped God was in Acts 12. The only thing that ever stopped God was the doors of a praying church. He said, Pharaoh couldn't stop me. Jericho couldn't stop me. The lion's den couldn't stop me. The fiery furnace couldn't stop me. Herod couldn't stop me. But my man stood outside a door knocking, because the only way I could get in was for the church to get up and to open the door. I've got a word tonight. He has heard our prayer. And the miracle has already been brought from the heavenly host. And it's knocking at our door. Am I preaching to anybody that's going to get up and open the door? I don't want a praying church to stop God from doing what he has already ordained to do. Oh, clap your hands unto the Lord and shout unto God. Come on, raise your voice and shout. Do you feel the Holy Ghost? We got to lift. Let's just lift him up a little higher. I come to say that you're holy. You're mighty. You're wonderful. You're resplendent. I glorify your name. I magnify your name. Over $1 million to missions today. Could somebody raise your hands and begin to cry unto the Lord? I thank you for it. You have your Bibles and we'll turn to Luke 11 and then to Isaiah 55. I understand my place tonight is to prepare an atmosphere for faith. I give honor to Brother Mangan, to all these wonderful men, and to the three men of my life. Brother Cisco, who could not be here tonight. My wonderful father, who's sitting right there. And to my bishop, Brother Tenney, who should have titled that sermon, Jonathan Suber, today. I told him he could have just come to me in private and really didn't have to get up in front of everybody and do that, but I receive it. Luke 11, and then we'll go to Isaiah 55. And I also want to say tonight for Brother Arnold and Brother Mangan, they may not know this. I'm a product. 22 years ago, my father came home from the first Because of the Times, totally changed. A man that had been raised in more traditional Pentecostal background, one from a denominational world as a teenager, sent to Bible school, came home to his young son, praying and fasting and believing revival, and then eventually led our family to Africa as missionaries. But I was called to preach. I figured it up today. 2 weeks after Because of the Times, when my father came home changed, something changed in me. And I accepted my call to preach while hearing Brother Jeff Arnold preach on tape, Formula for a Cloudburst, 22 years ago. And I stand here for the next generation that are products of Because of the Times. And Pastor Mangan, if it wasn't for you and this church and this meeting, I wouldn't be where I am in God and where I am in my life. But now that we're here, look at somebody and tell them, I'll holler if I have to. Luke 11 and verse 9. And I say unto you, ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh, receiveth. And he that seeketh, findeth. And to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. Isaiah 55 and verse 6. Seek ye the Lord, while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. I want to say it one more time. I'll holler if I have to. You can sit on your pew and fold your hands if you want to. But this whole message has led to this theme. I am desperate for a move of God. And I'll roll on the floor. I'll fast 40 days. I'll climb on top of pews. I'll holler if I have to. But whatever it takes, I've come to see a divine outpouring of the Holy Ghost and fire. Would you clap your hands unto God and all over this auditorium? Would you shout? Would you rejoice? Would you rejoice in the Holy Ghost? Come on, somebody, one more time. I'll holler. I'll holler. I'll open my mouth and I'll holler. If I have to. If I have to. You can be seated. I did not come to preach a prolific sermon. You have already deduced that. I understand that my place is not to sermonize and be homiletical or hermeneutically correct. But I pray that the gift of faith would be released in the next few moments. That somebody with a disease in their body, somebody with a spirit that wrapped themselves around them at home, would get out of their chair, kick their neighbor over, and say, get out of my way. I'll holler, I'll push, I'll move, but I'm not leaving tonight until I get my breakthrough. I didn't come in here to hear a sermon. I didn't come to sing the choir, but I come for a move of the Holy Ghost and fire. I'm tired of looking pretty. I'm tired of going in here and preaching and leaving like I came. I come for a change in the Holy Ghost. I come to be loose. I come to be set free. I come to get happy. I come to get my joy back. I wish I was preaching to some preacher. I come to get my joy back. I come to get my faith back. I come to get my shout back. I'll holler if I have to. I told Brother Arnold today, I said, you know what? At some point tonight, we're going to have to stop talking and start doing. We're going to have to stop saying, well, I wish we had miracles. And somebody's going to have to turn around and say, get up. Eye open. Cancer leave. Depression go. Finances, you're loosed in the name of Jesus. I am speaking to a prophetic people. I have come tonight to speak to a prophetic people. The one God, apostolic, tongue talking, aisle running, Jesus name, Holy Ghost Church. If you want to be a part of the first church of the frigid air, you need to slip out right now. But if I'm preaching to anybody that wants to step into the water, wade out a little bit deeper. Come on, somebody. I'm trying to behave. I'm preaching to a prophetic people. I would talk about prophets and prophetic messengers and prophetic cities and prophetic places that where there are geographical locations where there are prophetic messengers that are the angels of the church from the book of Revelation. I do believe that there is a prophetic realm that hell is scared to death. That somebody in here is going to realize I'm more than a converted mechanic. I'm more than a sanctified carpenter. I'm more than a pray-through drug addict. I am a man of God. I am a chosen vessel of God. I am the devil's worst nightmare. You didn't hear me. There's some of you, you've got a card in your pocket, but you don't have an assurance in your heart. You need to know beyond a matter of fact that God called you, God sent you, and greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. I feel him in my hands. I feel him in my feet. Am I preaching to somebody? You got a prophetic word from the Lord. I'm going home. I'm not going home to shout. I'm going home to cast out devils. I'm not going home to pout. I'm going home to take dominion over the works of the devil. I wish I could preach to somebody. The devil wants to steal your joy. The devil wants to kill your faith. And he wants to destroy your destiny. There's people that dragged in here. It's Tuesday night. You don't have joy. Oh, you're happy when you see your friends. You're happy when you paid your tuition. You're happy when you got through the motel and got in your room. But in your spirit, there was no joy. In your spirit, you say, I'm so tired. I'm so worried. I'm so fatigued. Hell is trying to steal your joy. Could I speak a word to somebody? If Jezebel is after you, you must be a prophet, because Jezebel doesn't chase anything but the prophetic. And if you're fighting the spirit of Jezebel, if you're fighting a spirit of confusion, if you're fighting a spirit of fear, it must be old Jesse. And if Jesse is looking for you, you must be a prophet of the one true God. Which, hey, you must be a prophet. I know some of you are laughing at me because I'm so simple. You're laughing at me because I'm just so crude. But I come to tell you something. If the devil is messing, God's getting ready for a blessing. You don't have a message until you've got a mess that matures. When you've got a mess that ages, then you've got a message. Some of you are in the middle of a mess. Just wait until the mess is over and you'll have a message. I wish I was hey, somebody hear me. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. I said weeping may endure for a night, but joy, Holy Ghost joy comes in the morning. The Bible said, with joy shall ye draw waters out of the well of salvation. Look at somebody and say, are you struggling to keep your joy? Are you struggling to keep your focus? Are you struggling to keep your faith? Because there's three things that Jezebel did to Elijah. First of all, she'll try to, I do have notes, she'll try to run you down. The first thing the spirit of Jezebel do will talk about you and try to get you to even doubt if you are a man of God. She'll begin to run you down. She'll begin to talk behind your back. Well, he doesn't preach the way he ought to preach. She doesn't sing the way she ought to sing. Well, honey, you didn't call me and you didn't send me. But I've got the Holy Ghost down in my soul. And it doesn't matter if I do it the way you would do it. I come against the spirit of Jezebel that's been running some of you down. There's some women in this church right now. You're about to go crazy because people are laughing at you. There's a preacher's wife here that's on the verge of a nervous breakdown. I wish you'd throw your hands right now. Open your mouth and holler. I'll holler if I have to. I'll holler if I have to. I'll get crazy if I have to. I'll get mad if I have to. Come on, preacher's wife. I'll holler. You're not pushing anybody out of the way yet. You're not getting mean yet. Are you waiting for a sermon? Or is there somebody, this is my night. This is my day. This is my miracle. This is my revival. This is my anointing. This is my day. This is my day. I got the joy. I got the joy. I got the joy. Look at somebody, say, she'll try to run you down. Then the spirit of Jezebel will try to run you out. I wish I was preaching to some prophetic people. If you're a prophetic people, would you wave at me? If you would say, there's a spirit that's been trying to drive me out of my anointing, trying to drive me out of my destiny, trying to drive me out of my ministry. I think I'll park my truck. I think I'll leave my church. I'll just get a job at Walmart. Honey, that's a devil from the pit of hell. You ought to holler. You ought to holler. You ought to holler. Gonna let a spirit of Jezebel run me out, run me away from my purpose. I have a purpose. I have a passion. God called me. God put me here. You can sit down if you want to. I got a word. Just give me a minute. Now listen. There's some of you that are giving the devil too much glory. You're talking about how bad it is. Instead of talking about how bad it is, why don't you rejoice that if you've got a test, it means you're going to have a testimony that these are they that overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. And I'm preaching to somebody right now. Don't you let the devil run you down, and don't you let Jezebel run you out. Am I preaching to somebody right now? You're about that far from a miracle, and hell is lying on you. You're about that far from a miracle, and hell... You're about to build that building. Your backslidden children are about to come back to God. But if Jezebel can run you out, there won't be anybody home when Bobby comes back. If the devil can run you off, what's going to happen to your city? I come to tell somebody, you need to get desperate right now. A spirit of Jezebel is not going to run. I holler. I got to get to my text, but I feel like preaching it here. You can sit down if you want to. And if she can't run me down, and if she can't run me out, then she's going to try to run me crazy. We find the man of God saying, I'm all by myself. Why don't you kill me? I got a suicide spirit on me. I know I can't kill myself, Lord. Why don't you kill me? Has anybody prayed that? I've had phone calls that if it wasn't for me going to hell, Brother Super, I would just end it all. I've come to tell you, if you feel that desperate, that it's not God's fault, it's the devil's fault. And you're that far from your miracle, you're that far high. Don't you let the devil run you crazy. I wish somebody would grab your head right now and say, I'm getting my mind back. I'm tired of losing my mind. I'm tired of losing my faith. I want my mind back. I want my mind back. I want my thoughts back. I want my mind. Come on, pray. I want my mind back. I want my clarity back. I want my anointing back. I want my victory back. Come on. I want my preach back. I want my preach back. I want my anointing back. I'm not preaching to everybody, but am I preaching to somebody? I'm not preaching to everything, but am I preaching to something? Is anybody here that says, I've lost my preach, I've lost my step, I dread going to the pulpit, but I holler if I have to, I'll sweat if I have to, I'll shout if I have to, I'll run if I have to, I'll pray if I have to. There's three dimensions of faith. You may see it now. I want to talk about desperation. There's three dimensions of faith. There's saving faith. There's healing faith. I had all this on the PowerPoint, but I'm just skipping through.
Okay.
There's saving faith. There's healing faith. But then there is desperate faith. If you are fighting a spirit of hell, you don't have time for mealy-mouth faith. You don't have time for denominational faith. You don't have time for faith that you read in somebody's book that don't even have the Holy Ghost. You got to get that belly-wrenching, gut-jerking faith that said, if I can but touch the hem of his garment, I'll holler, I'll holler, I'll push, I'll shove. You gotta have desperate faith. I had faith to get saved. I had faith to get healed. But I've got faith right now to push through the crud that's been messing in my marriage, messing in my finances, messing in my home, messing in my church. Have I got anybody here that's got a desperate faith? Do you feel like pushing past your checkbook, pushing past your bank account, pushing past your trouble, pushing past your heartache? Tell somebody, I holler if I have to. Sit down. Matthew 15. A Canaanite woman came to Jesus. I read it in the King James Version, and it said that she began to cry unto him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. But the NAS Version said that she shouted, she hollered, have mercy, thou son of David. And the disciples came up to him and said, get rid of this woman, because we are tired of her shouting. Jesus said, get back, because it is not her position I'm listening to. It is her desperation. She is not worthy, but she is ready. She is not worthy, but she desires it. Am I preaching to anybody here? You're not worthy. You've made mistakes. You're the least in the kingdom. But I holler if I have to. I shout if I have to. I'll scream past the preacher. I'll climb out the choir loft. I'll climb over the sound system. I'll climb through the crowd. Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. I want you to hear what I'm trying to say right now. She was more desperate than she was concerned about her position. She knew who she was. But I wish somebody would get a revelation of who he is. Because he is so merciful that he'll look beyond your faults and find your need. So therefore, your level of faith must be based upon your level of need. And the greater your need, the greater your desperation. The greater your need, the greater a revelation of how great he is. He's the great I am, the everlasting Father. He is the eternal wonder. Would somebody begin to clap your hands unto Jesus? I'm talking about Jesus. I'm talking about Jesus. Just stay with me. I'm not going to take long. But I'm asking somebody tonight, how desperate are you? Jesus is in Jericho. See, we've been talking about passion. Oh, I'm going to have passion when I go home. I'm going to have purpose when I go home. When are we going to stop having church and climb out of the aisle and say, I'm not leaving till this growth falls off. I'm not leaving till this cataract slides out my eye. I'm not leaving till my arm straightens. Am I preaching to anybody in here that's desperate right now? The angel of healing is here. The spirit of faith is here. But somebody needs to open their mouth and holler. Somebody needs to shout. Somebody needs to say, Jesus, 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 Jesus. When are we going to stop having church and loose the Holy Ghost? Let God arise. Let his enemies be scattered. Let God arise. Let his enemies be scattered. Let God arise. Come on, get him up. Get him up. Get him up. Oh, I'm waiting for a good point. I don't have any good points. I studied for 2 months and I didn't find anything except if I can just holler, if I can just open my mouth and open my spirit and say, Jesus, have mercy on my money. Have mercy on my marriage. Have mercy on my children. Have mercy on my church. Right now, raise your hand. There's miracles here right now. There's a demonstration here right now. Pray in the Holy Ghost even now. Pray in the Holy Ghost even now. Pray in the Holy Ghost even now. Pray in faith even now. Pray in faith even now. Pray in faith even now. feel. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. The Bible said, cry aloud. Call on the Lord while He is near. Call on the Lord while He is near. The gift of faith is rising up in you. The gift of faith is rising up in you. Miracles are happening right now. The energy of the Holy Ghost is moving right now. The power of the delivering Spirit of the living God. I plead the blood of Jesus. I activate the cross of Jesus. I activate the atonement of Jesus. Stretch forth your hand and believe healing on Brother Keys. Believe the divine power of the Holy Ghost upon our elder. By the authority of the gift of faith, infirmity and infection and disease go. Tell somebody, I'll holler. Come on, tell her, I'll holler. If I have to. Are you with me? I'm about through. Blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, is sitting as a beggar, but he hears Jesus is coming. His infirmity had become his identity. I'm tired of being poor old Jonathan. Are you tired of being the little church across town? Are you tired of being sick Sally and depressed Doug? Is there anybody here that says, I'm tired of being where I've been? But I'll holler if I have to. I'll holler if I have to. Come on, say, hey, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy. Then somebody said, shut up, shut up, be quiet, sit down, get comfortable, go back the way you were. I can't leave the way I came. I can't go home the way I came. I can't go back the way I came. I can't preach the way I came. I can't pray the way I came. So I holler. If I have to. I don't think you're hearing me. I can't go back the way I came. What you gonna do about it? You gonna sit down? You gonna calm down? You gonna fold your arms? Or does somebody come to holler? Did somebody come say, excuse me? Excuse me. Tonight's my night in the balcony. Tonight's my night. Be quiet. Calm down. Quit singing that way. Quit shouting. Quit leaping. Quit praying. Quit fasting. Calm down. Calm down. Calm down. Calm down. I'll holler. I can't stop preaching. I can't stop singing. I can't stop shouting. I'm desperate. I'm desperate. Stay with me and I'm out of here. Time's over. Woo. Now, there's another story. You've got to go home and read it. There was, in the other book, the other disciple talked about two blind men in Jericho. Didn't name them, but it said they hollered too. The Canaanite woman hollered. Bartimaeus hollered. And they hollered. But then in Luke 17, we leave the blind and the afflicted, and we find the leprous. Those that were falling apart. Just stay with me. I'm about through, but I'm just... Now, this is where I'm at. Come on. I'm preaching now to people that walked in here falling to pieces. My nerve, I feel, I'm feeling at home now. My nervousness done jumped out the window. They've fallen to pieces. A year here. A bankruptcy here. A divorce here. A backslidden child here. A lesbian daughter here. A suicide in their family here. And we don't want to get real and start crying out to Jesus. We got our church clothes on. We've been with the priest. But honey, the priest couldn't do nothing for you. When you're falling apart, the priest couldn't help them. They said, why don't you leave the tabernacle? Why don't you leave the temple? Go sit outside the city. We can't help you here, Brother Dean. We can only help perfect people here in our church. But when they heard Jesus was passing by, they said, I'll forget church and go find Jesus. I come to preach to somebody. I wish you'd forget your church shout. I wish you'd forget your church dance. I wish you'd forget your sanctified handshake. And you'd holler. You'd holler. I come in here falling to pieces. I come in here in. I've got a nose here, an ear here, a leg here, but Jesus. Right now, right now, right now, right now. Is there anybody here? Did anybody here leave a piece of themselves at home? I'll holler if I have to. Did anybody here leave a piece of yourself at home? Your mortgage is due. You gave in the missions offering and you can't even pay the light bill. You've been shouting with the music and you don't even have a piano player. But it's not about church. It's about Jesus. And Jesus is here right now. Just reach out and touch. And touch. I wish somebody would holler. I wish somebody would holler. I wish somebody would holler. Now, hey, I left it at home, but I'll holler if I have to. Here we go. They hollered, they cried out, lifted up their voices. That word meant holler. They didn't say, Jesus, please, Lord, if it be your will. Hey! Jesus! Hey! Jesus! They won't even let me in church. But Jesus! They won't let me preach anymore. But Jesus! They won't let me sing anymore. But Jesus! Thou Son of David! Have mercy! I'm falling apart. The Bible said that he touched them and said, go show the priest. And they were healed and they went and were cleansed. But one of them wasn't satisfied with just hollering to get it. He said, I hollered to get it and I hollered to keep it. This one comes running back to Jesus, crying with a loud voice. And he said, it wasn't enough to get touched. I want to be completely whole. I've had a touch this conference, but there's still a piece of my ear at home. I've still got a member of my family that's out there. I've still... got a disease in my body. But if hollering got me touched, if hollering got me saved, then hollering is going to make me whole. So I holler to get it, and I holler to keep it. I'll keep it. I'll keep it. I'll keep it. I'll keep it. Shout, 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 shout. I'm through preaching. But if you waste this sermon, you're crazy. Somebody needs to push out of the way and start hollering right now. Come on, woman. Come on, preacher. Come on, man. Come on, get out. Come on, cancer. Come on, diabetes. Come on, high blood pressure. Come on, depression. I'll holler. I'll holler. Oh, holler. Give out. Come here. Yeah, 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 yeah. Push out. Push out. Push out. It's desperate faith. It's healing faith. It's miracle faith. Every preacher, turn around and talk in tongues. Lay hands on somebody. It's miracle time. It's deliverance time. It's faith time. It's joy time. It's demonstration time. It's time for demonstration. It's time for the demonstration of the Holy Ghost and fire.
Somebody get up on the pews and lay hands on one another. Come on, take a hold of somebody. Some preacher, get up and walk the pews right now. Come on, there's another deliverance in the house. Come on up and down those aisles. Come on in the balcony. God has invaded us again. That's it, Brother Causey, receive it. That's it, Sister Causey. Come on, some of you get over here and pray for these missionaries. I need some preachers to get over here and walk these pews and pray for these missionaries. I need y'all to come pray for the missionaries. That's it. Go walk those pews and lay hands on the missionaries. Go lay hands on the missionaries. Their deficits are going to be taken care of. Their children are going to be saved. I'm going to holler. I'm going to holler. I'm going to holler. Come on, choir, lay hands on one another. Don't watch the church right now. Come on, Dennis, get what you need from God. I'm going to holler if I want to. Get up and walk there. Up there in the balcony, somebody get up in those pews and lay hands. Come on over there on the risers, lay hands. Fresh fire. Deliverance has hit this place again. Yet. God's got something for you. made whole.
Thank you.
Okay, start dancing back to your seat. We're going to hear another message here in a minute. I'm going to holler if I have to. And I'm going to holler because I want to. And I'm going to holler whether they want me to holler or not. When the crowd says, "Be quiet," I'm going to holler much the louder. Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me.